Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. For those of you new to my channel, my name is Abigail and I'm a mum, a wife and nurse manager. Today I'm going to talk about career progression, which is relevant to a lot of professions, so definitely don't shy away from sharing this video and don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. Stay tuned. So welcome back. Let's talk career progression. So career progression is basically moving up the career ladder. I'm going to start off by talking about being a newbie. Even though being a newbie is not necessarily part of the career progression plan, I definitely want to talk about it because it's a natural part of the process. And then I'm going to talk about five factors that I think should definitely be included in any career progression plan. Those five factors are discouragement, motivation, education and research, networking, and stakeholders. So let's start with being a newbie. Being a newbie is an inevitable part of the process and it can't be skipped. I remember when I was newly qualified and new to the unit at the time. It was a unit for cancer treatments and a lot of other things cancer related. And I remember it being very fast paced and there was a huge experience gap between a lot of the other nurses that were already working there and I. And I just remember being very nervous and being very shy. Although I don't know what shy has to do with anything, especially being in a workplace, but I was definitely very shy and very nervous. And I used to get overwhelmed at times, particularly to do with staff interactions. And I'd just go into the bathroom or go into the break room and just to calm myself down and kind of de-escalate and basically to hold myself together to avoid kind of saying anything out of anger or frustration. I felt like I constantly had eyes on me and that I was being monitored all the time. Which is normal, as you can imagine, it was a very specialized unit and you have to be shown how to do tasks properly and how to do things properly. But I was just very overwhelmed and very shy and very nervous. And as you can imagine, all those factors put together can be quite intimidating. But the newbie phase can be very tough, but you'll definitely get through it. Just a quick tip. If there's someone in your organization that's a bit friendly towards you. Now, I know there's always one of these in every organization. If you find that person, definitely try and gravitate towards that person because I think it kind of helps with lightening things up and I think it improves your natural association with work being that cold new place. Now enough about being a newbie. Let's move on to the first of the five factors, discouragement. Discouragement comes in different ways and I found that there were definitely two types that affected me in my career. The first being self-inflicted and the second being as a result of my environment, organization or colleagues. With the self-inflicted type, I found that I suffered from imposter syndrome, and I feel like I still kind of do from time to time. You know, random feelings of doubting my own achievement and almost feeling like an imposter or a fraud in my own position. Whenever I find myself in this state, I just try to reflect and remind myself of how I got to where I am, and basically try to accept that I played a huge role in my own success. I think that's a really good way of dealing with it if you do suffer from imposter syndrome. It's definitely worked for me. Now with the second type, I found that I had a lot to do with the organization and environment. I would try to take on extra courses that were relevant to my role at the time and just improve my own knowledge and skills and practices, but find that I'm restricted due to various things like staffing constraints, a lot of which couldn't be helped at the time. And then being told that you're not ready to do certain courses or certain tasks, but then being encouraged by other senior colleagues to do those same things. And I just remember just feeling very frustrated by the inconsistencies in advice. Now, these are my examples and yours may very well be different, but regardless, they're definitely very valid. And how I've been overcoming discouragement is just with time and keeping my eye on the prize. Which brings me on to my next topic or the next factor, motivation. Motivation is very important to keep you on track towards your career progression plan. It's very important to stay focused, stay driven, and stay motivated. I remember being at work and getting frustrated at times, and I tell my colleagues that I just want to have kids and be a housewife. Yeah, I have a kid now, and I would rather be at work. But anyway, that's a story for another day. I'm actually going to do some videos on motherhood and my experience of motherhood in the future. And yeah, anyway, back to the topic. You have to figure out what keeps you driven and what keeps you motivated. For me, it's simply keeping my eye on the goal and basically time. But for a lot of other people, I'm sure there are other things that help them keep motivated. And definitely take baby steps as well and engage with things and keep yourself preoccupied with things that will keep you on track towards your plan. Which brings me on to my next topic, education and research. Great way to keep preoccupied. Education and research is really good for self-development. And I talked a lot about self-development in my last video. If you haven't seen it, you should definitely watch it. I'll leave a link in the description box below. As part of your career progression plans, it's important to continue education and continue to acquire knowledge that's relevant to your career aspirations. I enrolled in a lot of courses. I did a short course in hematology, I did a short course in oncology, I did a short course in leadership and management, I did my diploma in cancer care and hematology, and I also did my master's in cancer care and hematology. My point is to avail of any educational opportunities available in your organization. And then there's research. Research is prevalent in every organization, every service, every business, every market. Just try and get involved in research any way you can because it's important for your career progression plans as well. Find out about new developments and new practices and try to incorporate them into your own local practices. As a nurse, I've played an active role in research within my organization. From mobile efficient ways of assessing patient symptoms to administering chemotherapy to patients so that they can have it at home instead of having it in a hospital. I mean, it's all part of experience accumulation and definitely try and get involved in research whatever way you can. The next factor is networking. Now, if you're not going to listen to anything that I've said today, you definitely need to listen to this. You need to network. Networking is huge. It enables you to improve your skills. It helps you to keep up with trends. It helps you to meet other professionals, and it helps you to meet prospective mentors. It basically equips you with the resources that you need for when you're ready to take the bull by the horn. So attend professional gatherings, attend work gatherings, attend professional presentations, just make yourself visible. And if you can, join work organizations or join professional organizations. Regardless of your profession, whether you're a nurse, whether you work at a supermarket, whether you're an accountant, whether you're a midwife, definitely try and join a professional organization that's relevant to your line of work. And the last factor is stakeholders. You must get to know your stakeholders within your organization, and you need to get to know them individually and prioritize them in accordance to their relevance to your career path. These are the people that have the power and influence over the day-to-day running of various things within your organization. They can also support your ideas and your work. They can also advance your career, so definitely win their support and engage with them. Now, I know some of you may be thinking that it's not as straightforward to move up the career ladder like I'm making it out to be. The truth is, it's not meant to be straightforward. There's politics in every organization and in every profession. You just have to be patient and be strategic and wait for the right opportunity. And when that opportunity comes, apply your strategy efficiently and effectively. You may also be looking in the wrong place. Sometimes you need to think outside the box and step outside your comfort zone. In my last video, I talked about how I left the clinical area to go into an IT role as a manager and then come back in to a clinical area as a manager. So sometimes you have to step out of your comfort zone and then get back in on your career path. There's definitely a lot of other issues that affect career progression as well. There are some personal issues. Some people are going on career breaks. Some people are rearing kids. Some people have family problems that they're dealing with. But the beauty of it is that everyone's journey is different. So that concludes today's topic. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you have any questions or any suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. And if you haven't already done so, please share this video and don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. And also follow me on Instagram @TheNurseAbigail. See you next time.